In these trying times, our people and our industry have exhibited remarkable resilience. As institutions absorb more, we shall commit more. A king or a ruler is the one who creates and acquires wealth, protects and distributes it for common good. Thirukkural. I present the budget for the year 2021-2022. New centrally sponsored scheme, PM Atmanirbhar Swasth Bharat Yojana, will be launched with an outlay of about 64,180 crores over 6 years. This will develop capacities of primary, secondary and tertiary care health systems, strengthen existing national institutions and create new institutions to cater to detection and cure of new and emerging diseases. The Jal Jeevan Mission Urban will be launched. It aims at universal water supply in all 4,378 urban local bodies with 2.86 crores household tap connections as well as liquid waste management in 500 Amrit cities. It will be implemented over 5 years with an outlay of 2,87,000 crores. Swachh Bharat and Swasth Bharat. For further Swachhata of urban India, the Urban Swachh Bharat Mission 2.0 will be implemented with a total financial allocation of 1,41,678 crores over a period of 5 years from 2021. Clean air. To tackle the burgeoning problem of air pollution, I propose to provide an amount of 2,217 crores of rupees for 42 urban centers with a million plus population in this budget. Our government is committed to the welfare of farmers. The MSP regime has undergone a sea change to assure price that is at least 1.5 times the cost of production across all commodities. In case of wheat, the total amount paid to farmers in 2013-14 was 33,874 crores. In 2019-20, it was 62,802 crores. And even better, Honorable Speaker, in 2020-2021, this amount paid to farmers was 75,060 crores. For paddy, the amount paid in 2013-14 was 63,928 crores. In 2019-20, this increased to 1,41,930 crores. This is further estimated to increase to 1,72,752 crores. The number of farmers benefited increased from 1.24 crores in 2019-20 to 1.54 crores in 2020-21. Early this year, Honorable Prime Minister had launched the Swamitva scheme. Under this, a record of rights is being given to property owners in villages. Up till now, about 1.80 lakh property owners in 1,241 villages have been provided cards. I propose during 21-22 to extend this to cover all states and union territories. I have enhanced the agricultural credit target to 16.5 lakh crores in this year. Keeping in view the transparency and the competitiveness that eNAM has brought into the agricultural market, 1,000 more mandis will be integrated with eNAM. I propose to launch a portal that will collect relevant information on gig workers, building and construction workers, among others. This will help formulate health, housing, skill, insurance credit and food schemes for all migrant workers. Social security benefits will be extended to gig and platform workers. Minimum wages will apply to all categories of workers. Women will be allowed to work in all categories and also in the night shifts with adequate protection. We have taken a number of steps to support the MSME sector. In this budget, I have provided 15,700 crores to this sector, more than double of the last year's B. I propose to provide 1,000 crores for the welfare of tea workers, especially women and children in Assam and West Bengal. A special scheme will be devised for the same. 100 new sainik schools will be set up in partnership with NGOs, private schools and states. For accessible higher education in Ladakh, I propose to set up a central university in Leh. We have set ourselves a target of establishing 750 Eklavya model residential schools in our tribal areas. I propose to increase the unit cost of each such school from 20 crores, which is what it is now, to 38 crores, and for hilly and difficult areas, 48 crores. This would help creating robust infrastructure facilities for our tribal students. We are allotting 35,219 crores for 6 years till 25-26 to benefit 4 crores scheduled caste students. Our tax system has to be transparent, efficient, and should promote investments and employment in our country. At the same time, it should put minimum burden on our taxpayers. We slashed our corporate tax rate to make it among the lowest in the world. The dividend distribution tax too was abolished. The burden of taxation on small taxpayers was eased by increasing rebates. The fiscal deficit in BE21-22 is estimated to be 6.8% of the GDP. The gross borrowing from the market for the next year would be around 12 lakh crores. We plan to continue with our path of fiscal consolidation and intend to reach the fiscal deficit level below 4.5% of the GDP by 2025-2026, with a fairly steady decline over the period. Scrapping policy. We are separately announcing, Honorable Speaker, a voluntary vehicle scrapping policy to phase out old and unfit vehicles. This will help in encouraging fuel-efficient, environment-friendly vehicles, thereby reducing vehicular pollution and oil import bills. Vehicles would undergo fitness tests in automated fitness centers after 20 years in case of personal vehicles, and after 15 years in case of commercial vehicles. More than 13,000 kilometer length of roads at a cost of 3.3 lakh crores has already been awarded under the 5.35 lakh crores Bharat Mala Pariyojana project, of which 3,800 kilometers have been constructed. By March 2022, we would be awarding another 8,500 kilometers and complete an additional 11,000 kilometers of national highway corridors. To further augment road infrastructure, more economic corridors are also being planned. I am also providing an enhanced outlay of 1,18,101 crores for Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, of which 1,08,230 crores is for capital, the highest ever provided. Honorable Speaker, sir, Indian Railways have prepared a National Rail Plan for India 2030. The plan is to create a future-ready railway system by 2030. High-density network and highly utilized network routes of Indian Railways will be provided with an indigenously developed automatic train protection system that eliminates train collision due to human error. I'm providing a record sum of 1,10,055 crores for railways, of which 1,07,100 crores is for capital expenditure only. Two new technologies, that is Metro Lite and Metro Neo, will be deployed to provide metro rail systems at much lesser cost with same experience, convenience and safety in Tier 2 cities and peripheral areas of Tier 1 cities also. Greater domestic value addition, we are withdrawing a few exemptions on part of charges and subparts of mobiles. Further, some parts of mobiles will move from nil rate to a moderate 2.5%. We are reducing customs duty uniformly to 7.5% on semis, flats and long products of non-alloy, alloy and stainless steels. To provide relief to copper recyclers, I'm reducing duty on copper scrap from 5% to 2.5%. We are uniformly reducing the BCD rates on caprolactam nylon chips, nylon to 5%. Prices of precious metals have risen sharply. To bring it closer to previous levels, we are rationalizing customs duty on gold and silver. We are rationalizing exemption on import of duty-free items as an incentive to exporters of garments, leather and handicraft items. We are raising customs duty on cotton from nil to 10%, on raw silk and silk yarn from 10 to 15%. With these words, I commend the budget to this august house. Thank you.